Marriage is a divine project of God. The Bible says in Genesis 2 verse 18, "Now the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone." Who said? The Lord God, not you, not your friend, not your mother, not your father. But the Lord God said, and that is why you need to allow God to be your project supervisor. Marriage is a divine project of God. If you don't allow God to supervise the project, you are bound to fail. You didn't start it. God started marriage. If you start your marriage journey without God, it will lead to regret. How do I know? Whatever men do outside God cannot fulfill divine purpose. It all begins with God. Don't just involve God. Allow God to involve you and engage you about who to marry. Don't just carry God along. Just tell him anyhow you want it. Allow God to carry you along. Remember, it was God who brought Eve to Adam, not the other way around. I am not saying if you see a sister, you cannot pray about it. Or if you felt led to a brother, you can pray about it. You can talk to God about it. But let God be the first priority. Don't move ahead of God. That is what I'm saying. Marriage is a great tool in the hand of a great God. But now, marriage has become a gruesome tool in the hand of sinful men. God has something in mind when he instituted marriage. When we don't know that purpose, abuse is inevitable, as we can see in our world today. So let's go back to God. Let's ask him to help us. Because marriage started with God. You can't know true love outside God. You can't. The kind of love that keeps a home can only be taught by God himself, not by man. God created marriage for his purpose and by extension for the benefit of mankind. It is first about God, then about you. So not about you first, then later God. Where we all miss it is that we put ourselves first, then God second, and some people, no place for God. God is not in the equation. When we think about relationship or marriage, we selfishly think about what we want first. Doesn't work that way. Some get into relationship because everyone around them has boyfriend or girlfriend. Some because of sexual pleasure. Some because they want to make their parents happy. Because the parents have been expecting them to bring somebody home. Some want to have children even without marriage. Some because of connections or contracts. Some because they just want to prove a point to their family. And that is all. Those are not the reason. Those are wrong reasons. Because we get into marriage for wrong reasons, that is why we run into so many troubles. So when our selfish expectations are not met, we are quick to abandon the marriage and run away. And that is what we see all over today. Imagine a man or woman who just get married to have children. I mean, the focus is just about children. He doesn't want to have children, that is all. Once there is a little delay in childbearing, the union is in big trouble. The family is in big trouble. A lady who got married because of riches stands the chance of running away if the man has financial crisis for a long time. Because our focus is about money. So marriage is not about you first. It is about God. It is a project of God on earth. If you subscribe to it, you must be ready. You must be ready to fulfill the purpose in the mind of God, the purpose of the project. You can't determine the purpose. Only the project owner